Hey everybody, how's it going?
Today, let's take a detailed look at the 2008 BMW 550i. And this is going to be a full, in-depth tour of the 550. We'll start up, show the engine, get an exhaust clipping over the performance data, as well as show you a few of the unique aspects of the interior, as well as the exterior.
And before we begin, I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to South Coast Autos, located in Houston, Texas, for inviting me out to film a wide variety of automobiles and helping support my first ever trip to Texas. For more information about this particular car or other vehicles in their inventory, feel free to check out southcoastautos.com.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up. Let her run.
The exterior color is known as titanium silver metallic, featuring an all-black premium leather interior. The 550 also comes standard with a push-button ignition. All you have to do is take the key fob, put it in the slot and steering column, and then hit the button to go. Beautiful, potent sound from that V8. The 550 features variable ratio, speed proportional, rack and pinion power steering, and a beautiful leather steering wheel, 3-spoke, accented by some satin silver, and your multifunction controls on either side of these spokes. And as far as the gearbox, this particular vehicle is equipped with a 6-speed, electronically controlled automatic gearbox and this unique shift housing. Basically, to put it into drive, you hit this unlock button off to the side here, and just put it down. Tip it once up for neutral. But to go in reverse, you have to hit the unlock and push it all the way up. Once in reverse, your side mirrors tilt down, as well as your activation of your parking sensors. And if you want to shift the vehicle manually, all you have to do is just tap it up or down via the plus and the minus to go either down or up a gear respectively. And to put it in park, just hit the P on top. If you're in one of the sport modes or manual shifting modes, the shift column will actually slide over into its parking gear. All accented in polished silver, with an aluminum housing. And so, we can flip on the automatic headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. All four windows are fully automatic. And we're gonna check out the exterior, shall we? The E65 series generation first appeared back in 2004, replacing the E39 gen, and was available in both sedan and wagon variants that spanned from the basics to the ultra-high performance M5 sedan. During its run, it racked up record sales and many awards. BMW refreshed the E60 for 2008 that included a redesigned front clip, LED tail lamps, improved electronics, and a pair of new 6-cylinder engines for the 528i and the 535i. Not to mention, there's also two transmissions available for the vehicle, including a new 6-speed automatic gearbox with manual shifting capabilities, as well as a standard 6-speed ZF manual transmission. The automatic gearbox decreases shift times by about half and increases throttle response by about 40% over the previous offerings. Improved efficiency thanks to brake regeneration and new engine technologies also helped improve economy by about 25%. All playing a part in BMW's efficient dynamics program that looks at weight, dynamics, and consumption to make more power while using less fuel in a lighter vehicle. The 550i is essentially the bridge between the turbocharged 535i and the 5-liter V10 powering the M5. It features a naturally aspirated 32-valve dual overhead cam, all-aluminum 4.8-liter V8 engine that pumps out 360 horsepower at 6,300 RPM and 360 pound-feet of torque at 3,400 RPM. This leads to a 0 to 60 time of 4.8 seconds and a quarter mile time of 13.3 seconds at 105.1 miles per hour. Top speed is electronically limited to 155 miles per hour. And with an 18.5-gallon fuel tank on required premium fuel, expect a miles per gallon rating of 15 city, 22 highway. This 550 also features the sport package that gives it a little bit of an M5 flavor with unique front, rear, and side clips that give it a lower, more aggressive stance. Also, unique 19-inch double-spoke aluminum alloy wheels. They're wrapped in 245/35 tires in front and wider 275/30 tires in the rear. The brace consists of 13.7-inch vented discs in front and 13.6-inch vented discs in the rear that help bring the car to a stop from 60 miles an hour in a very short 108 feet. The car also features a fully independent suspension with McPherson struts in front and a multi-link rear with coil springs and anti-roll bars. All of the refinements in power and comfort also came at a price hitch, which you would expect from a German sport executive sedan such as this. When it was brand new, the 550i could fetch easily around $69,000 MSRP, so finding them on the second-hand market is definitely quite a bargain if you're able to find one in good condition. The interior of this 550i is composed of dark, rich materials, but is available in a few different color schemes. Build quality is excellent, with soft-touch material covering just about every surface, including the iDrive controller. Stitched across the door panels and armrests, and all finished off with dark, high-gloss wood veneers. Your power windows and mirrors are located on the door alongside your power folding mirrors. As far as the seating, the 550 comes standard with 20-way sport leather bucket seats with 4-way power lumbar, a thigh extension, and independent adjustment for your upper back. They're quite comfortable and hug you in with great lateral grip in all of the right places, and even have an adjustable head cushion built into the headrest, kind of like what you would see on a first-class airplane seat. Not to mention, side curtain airbags up top and down below across the doors. Logoed floor mats as well as an aluminum logoed door sill plaque, your trunk release down below next to the hood release, and it's a full power tilt telescoping steering wheel.
So let's go and see if she sounds. Beautifully free revving engine. So let's go ahead and shut her up. Nice soft closing door panels. The 5 Series features a premium audio system as standard, but also features the iDrive Mobile Media Navigation Telemetrics Interface, controlled by this little controller in the middle. This is pretty much the first generation. This particular one doesn't have navigation, but it has all the functionality that you would typically have for your telephone, entertainment, climate, and car data. We'll go through all that in its appropriate part in the video. But first, the radio. The standard system definitely packs a punch. AM FM with satellite radio capabilities, as well as an in-dash CD player. Side curtain airbags. Auto-dimming rearview mirror with integrated garage home link located down below. Up top,
your hands-free Bluetooth microphone, SOS emergency roadside assistance, interior illumination, as well as reading lamps, not to mention the controls for your fully automatic sunroof. Now, as far as the mobile media system, like I mentioned, it's all controlled by the iDrive controller located in the center console. This wheel right here, click up, down, left, and right, twist back and forth, and hit down for enter to go through all the different menus. This is your main menu button right here, and it'll bring you to the home screen, where it shows the radio station, clock, as well as the different options. So, if you just click down, it'll bring up this little set of menus here. Up at the top, where it's highlighted, you can scroll back and forth to go through the different main menus, basically. Turning off the display, click the one you desire to bring up the little sub-menus. This particular one is all the personalizable options of the vehicle, including your audio adjustments. To go back, hit the menu button, and you can click the wheel up to go back over to the main menus. Climate data, various vent settings, customizing options, communication for your hands-free Bluetooth telephone, not to mention BMW concierge services, roadside assistance. Pretty nifty. Car data, basically the vehicle just diagnostics. You can set a speed limit so it'll warn you if you ever hit a certain speed that you didn't want to go over. And entertainment down below. So you can select through your presets here. Manual tune, see all the available stations in the area. If you click all the way to the top, go through the different media options, iPod, auxiliary integration, weather band, satellite radio. So in a nutshell, those are all the basic features of the iDrive system in the 550i. Continue down the center console, your lock and unlock is right below your hazard switch, standard dual zone, electronic automatic climate control with your fan speed in the middle, one touch automatic, front and rear defrost, AC and recycling, as well as your independent zone adjustments. Your CD player, presets, as well as activation of some of the other radio modes if you didn't want to go through the system itself. Little storage tray down below, traction settings, 3-stage heated seats, turning off your parking sensors, as well as a little lighter trash ashtray and or a 12-volt power outlet. Storage space down below, as well as a little console here. All the cup holders are located on the passenger side dash and they swing out. As far as the steering wheel, your wipers off to the left, cruise control all the way down, as well as your turn signal and driver info controls here to show up in the bottom of the speedometer cluster. Trip computer, fuel data. Give you radio controls, as well as hands-free telephone controls and voice commands. Help.
You can say the following commands. Dial number. Dial name. Save name. Delete name. System off.
You can mute the radio, as well as turn the screen off from the steering wheel. Your interior illumination brightness, or the switch gear and the gauges are all controlled by the little wheel next to the lighting switch. Alrighty. We're gonna shut her down. And we'll check out the back seat. Back seat room is excellent. Featuring equally sporty styling. As well as pretty good comfort. The seating is firm, but very supportive. Pretty typical of a German sedan. Rear air vents, two power outlets, as well as an auxiliary input. Rear illumination, rear side curtain airbags,
not to mention a fold-down armrest with storage. Alrighty. Now we're going to check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we?
The trunk lid is extremely easy to open and features around 14 cubic feet of cargo space. You have some side storage pockets on either end, with a little cargo net off to the right, some cargo tie downs, and it's also illuminated. Up in the top shelf, you also have an emergency roadside assistance kit.
Passenger seat features the same power adjustments, including two-person memory, as the driver's seat. Two cup holders, like I mentioned earlier, as well as a full lockable glove box, illuminated and lined with felt.
The 5 Series might as well be the standard of executive sports sedans. With attractive and aggressive styling, a variety of engines, and availability of a wagon, it seems to blend the best of everything. A great car to find on the second-hand market that blends raw performance and long-term comfort.
Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the 2008 BMW 550i. Be sure to stay tuned next time, there's a lot more where that came from. Take care everybody.